Wagwan, wagwan. Welcome back to the DIY Yardie channel. Welcome if it's your first time. In this video, I'm actually working on this Navien tankless hot water heater. It's flashing a code 3, error code 3, and it's basically not producing any hot water right now. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is get into it and, you know, give it run some tests and see what goes on here. And basically what that code 3 means is saying that it's not getting any gas or no gas to the system. Okay, so I'm gonna shut it down, and the first thing I'm gonna check here is my intake filter to make sure it's not clogged. The dirty intake filter can also, you know, cause this same issue. Okay, the filter has a little bit of dirt, but nothing that should cause that issue. I'm going to get that cleaned up and replace that. All right. So I ruled out this filter, but I still went ahead and cleaned it and put it back together. And I had actually did a descaling on this unit maybe a few weeks ago. So, you know, it was acting up, and after descaling, it did much better. Okay, so I gotta cut it back on and test it again. Have somebody run the water and see what happens. You know, like I said, it did a little better after the descaling, and I thought maybe that would solve the issue, but now it just completely quit. No hot water at all. Okay. So before it was producing, well, I would say kind of more of a lukewarm water, and the descaling brought the temperature back up, you know. All right, so that didn't work. So what I'm going to do is check the igniter. So what I'm doing here is I cut the gas off to the valve and shut the system down. And the reason why I'm checking the igniter, there's a little view glass inside at the burner here. And I noticed, well, I didn't see the igniter lighting up. Okay, so that just made me want to check the igniter, because they do burn out on these units. The igniters tend to burn out over, you know, over time. All right, so you can tell this one has been changed before. Somebody did some tape work here, like I guess, you know, trying to insulate the igniter wires. These do send high current through the igniter. All right, so I'm going to get those screws removed, and once I get these screws removed, I can pop the igniter out and see what it looks like. Most of these units, the tankless hot water heater units, they're, you know, they're similar. They might not be exact same design, but they are a lot similar, you know. So they'll typically have, you know, similar issues. All right, so taking a look at the igniter, you can tell right away there is my problem. So this one on the right is a new one. The one on the left is the old one. All right, and you can see the prongs are like completely gone. I'm actually surprised that this thing would even ignite at all, you know, the condition it's in. All right, so I got the new one back in, new one replaced. Now I'm going to hook my connections up. And the two right leads are for the igniter cables. Okay, so You pretty much can't mess this up. It's, you know, just be sure to shut the system down when you're doing any kind of service work. All right. And also, if you find this video helpful, you know, please consider subscribing to my channel. Give a thumbs up and, you know, share to anyone you know that might like or be interested in a video like this. All right. So kind of new to YouTube and I'm trying to get my channel up and going, you know. I'm getting there slowly but surely, but free subscriptions are free and it'll help me to grow my channel. All right. So the third wire is actually the flame rod, you know, the temperature sensor basically. All right. So got all three hooked up and gonna cut the gas back on. I do all of this as a safety precaution whenever I'm opening up the system. All right, then hit the switch. Okay, give it a minute or two and have somebody, once it shows that now the temperature, okay, then you can have somebody cut the water on and see how it goes. All right. So I'm gonna check my little view box here. There's a little window you can check to see if the igniter is lighting up. It should start to glow if the igniter is lighting up. And you can tell, you know, basically you run the closest tap to this system, and you can see it's starting to glow there. That's a good sign, and we're getting hot water. All right, so this is the part number for this unit. If you're interested, hope this video helped. That solved the problem. I am DIY Yachty, enough respect, bless up.